Tonight, the work begins on tracking down friends and family members of the first person diagnosed with Ebola here in the U.S. The man arrived in Dallas from Liberia on September 19th. He is critically ill. He is in isolation tonight in a Texas hospital. Since late July, the CDC says 12 people have been tested for Ebola in the U.S., but this is the only case so far that has tested positive. New here at 10, while the focus of this first case is in Dallas, the fight is taking place here in Nashville, too. News Channel 5's Todd Walker is live tonight at Vanderbilt Medical Center. And Todd, researchers there are hard at work on a vaccine.
Yeah, Jessica, it is hoped that over the next few months, the work done right here at Vanderbilt will help create some sort of effective treatment to stop the spread of Ebola throughout West Africa. Meanwhile, here at home, doctors are adamant there is no reason to panic.
Probably you'll need to adjust.
Last week, Senator Lamar Alexander toured the lab at Vanderbilt that hopes to bring the Ebola epidemic in West Africa under control. Only 6 days later, the focus of that fight has come a whole lot closer to home.
We received in our laboratory today specimens from the individual, tested them, and they tested positive for Ebola.
The first case of Ebola diagnosed in the U.S. at a Dallas hospital has brought undoubted nervousness nationwide.
We all expected that, anticipated it, and I think we're ready.
One of the nation's top infectious disease experts right here in Nashville says Americans should not be panicked about this case.
It's not going to get out and spread in the United States population. It's not going to spread in the United States population. It won't do that.
The virus is only spread by coming in contact with bodily fluids of a person who is already showing symptoms of Ebola, not before that. Dr. Schaffner says the U.S. medical system is much more sophisticated than what is in West Africa, so he's confident the virus can be contained and snuffed out much easier.
Hospitals have been for the past month or two practicing their infection control, just as we have here at Vanderbilt.
Meanwhile, the effort to snuff out the disease worldwide continues, not far from Schaffner's office.
That's all in process, and we hope it has a good result. All those tests are underway.
Vanderbilt researchers will be working with a company out of San Diego. That company helped create the vaccine, which treated two infected doctors which were brought to Atlanta from West Africa for treatment earlier this summer. Up until that point, that vaccine had only been tested in monkeys. The researchers here at Vanderbilt and in San Diego hope to mass produce that vaccine and make it safe for mass human use. We're live at Vanderbilt tonight. I'm Todd Walker, News Channel 5 HD.